Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. The subject at hand is FAPN, and this is the last topic or discussion under your FAPN course. Now we are going to be talking about the autonomic nervous system. This is equivalent to 10 points in your part 1 of the final. So you better listen and really focus so that you'll be able to get the questions. So we already discussed the central nervous system. Anong dalawang organ yun nandyan? You have your brain and spinal cord. Basically, this is the command center, no? Siya yung nagbibigay ng control to the rest of the body. It is also the one that receives the signals from all of the other organs and interprets that data. So, yung central nervous system natin, it is only able to control the different parts of our body by communicating with our peripheral nervous system. We discussed this last week. The peripheral nervous system is composed of your cranial nerves and your spinal nerves, no? And as mentioned, it is the communication line between the central nervous system and the rest of the body. Now, the peripheral nervous system is composed of two divisions. Your sensory division, which receives the impulses and the signals from all over the body and brings it to the CNS. While the other division is your motor or efferent division. Ito naman is the one that carries the signal or commands from the CNS and brings it to the muscles and the glands. Now, when there is a command from our central nervous system, depende pa kung saan darating yung signal. Will it go to a voluntary muscle or will it go to an involuntary muscle? So if it goes to a voluntary muscle or basically to a muscle that we can move at will, we call that somatic nervous system. So moving your arms, your legs, no? Moving the rest of your body, it falls under somatic nervous system. But for those muscles that we cannot control at will, ang nagko-control doon is what we call the autonomic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system. So, ano mga muscles ba yan that are involuntary? The muscles of your heart, your glands, and your smooth muscles, di ba? Saan ba nakikita yung smooth muscles natin? In our digestive system, in our respiratory system, and the many other systems in the body which cannot be controlled at will. And our autonomic nervous system is actually divided into two. Your sympathetic and your parasympathetic. So we will be discussing the autonomic nervous system and everything inside of it. And we'll start with understanding what the ANS is or what the autonomic nervous system is. Katulad ng sabi ko, ang kinokontrol ng autonomic nervous systems mo ay involuntary muscles or those automatic processes in the body. So we call that your GVE, motor system. Ano yung GVE? General, visceral, efferent. Efferent kasi motor, visceral kasi involuntary. Ba? So it's a GVE motor system. So it controls and regulates, as mentioned, smooth muscles, cardiac muscles, and glands. Yan, tatlong yan yung kinokontrol niya. And sabi ko kanina, it's only divided into two, pero meron din kinoconsider na third division, no? So, the first two are your sympathetic and parasympathetic. And then, other resources would include the third division, which is enteric division, which later on will also slightly touch upon. So, what I want you to understand, sa buong autonomic nervous system, whether sympathetic man yan or parasympathetic, it's composed of two types of neurons. The preganglionic neuron and the postganglionic neuron. Okay? So if you will see here, sabi natin, no, pag lumabas ng spinal cord, that's already a part of your peripheral nervous system. So, di ba, part ng peripheral ang autonomic. So, if you can see here, it's labeled vertebral ganglia. So, this already is a ganglia, no? So, before that, before you reach the ganglia, you call that the preganglionic neuron. And if it goes beyond the ganglia, you call that postganglionic neurons. Okay, so later, no? Puntahan pa natin yan. So, the autonomic nervous system, it is generally controlled by your hypothalamus. Okay? Ang output ng para or sympathetic nervous system natin, it is always influenced by your hypothalamus. So, ano bang ginagawa ng autonomic nervous system? It produces opposite effects in most organs, no? Ibig sabihin, yung effect ng sympathetic is the opposite of the effect of parasympathetic. Kung yung isa magko-constrict ng blood vessels, yung isa magdadilate ng blood vessels. Kung yung isa magi-increase ng heart contraction, yung isa magde-decrease ng heart contraction. So they produce opposite effects, no? And this is considered a physiologic antagonist kasi nga opposite sila ng ginagawa. And the reason why they are created in this way is that so they can create balance and maintain a stable internal environment. So we'll start with the sympathetic division first. Yung sympathetic division, you might read from other books, no? Tawag din nila dyan is thoracolumbar or adrenergic system. Tatandaan nyo lang kapag sympathetic division, it is preparing your body for an emergency. Ganun yung siya isipin. When you say sympathetic, it's preparing your body for an emergency. It is activating your fight, flight, and flight response. No? Let's say, you heard someone shout sunog. Diba? May sumigaw sunog. You will be amazed with yourself na mabubuhat mo yung refrigerator, which you normally could not even move. Diba? So, this kind of responses fall under sympathetic. No? Ito yung fight, flight, and flight response mo. And some of the effects include, pag sympathetic, no, pinapabilis niya yung tibok ng puso. Diba? In an emergency or when you wanna fight, tumibilis ang tibok ng puso. Or nararamdaman mo, nag-increase yung force of contraction. Malakas yung kabog ng dibdib. And in an emergency or pagtakot ka, nag-increase ang blood pressure. Diba? So those are the effects of your sympathetic division. And as you can see in the image, several organs are actually stimulated by the sympathetic division. Now, aralin natin tong course or pathway of your sympathetic division. Let's start with the preganglionic neurons. Always yan, may pre and then may post. So your preganglionic neurons originate from T1 to L3. You have here your T1 until bababa yan ng L3. So mula T1 hanggang L3, kasama yan sa sympathetic division. Specifically, the ventral root. Pag sinabi nating ventral root, anterior root. Inaral natin last week sa PNS na ang nasa posterior root or nasa dorsal root is your sensory. So, sinabi natin kanina, your autonomic nervous system is under motor. So, ventral root siya. Paglabas niya ng spinal cord, it will go to what you call white communicating rami. I'll just show you yan. Paglabas ng spinal cord anteriorly, it will go to a place or it will become a fiber called white communicating rami. Bakit communicating? Kasi if you will notice, no, itong fiber na ito, it went down and has a connection with the white ramus also of the next level of spinal cord. And then, siya rin, may connection siya sa ilalim. So, they communicate with one another. Kaya siya white communicating rami. Now, if you will notice also, no, merong enlargement dito. merong ganglia here, no? You call it the prevertebral or the collateral ganglia. Ano ba yung ganglia again? Sabi natin sa PNS, it is the collection of cell bodies. So, itong mga fibers natin ng white communicating ramae, there is a collection of cell bodies here forming your prevertebral or collateral ganglia. So, magsasama-sama yan. Pag pinagdikit-dikit mo yung mga ganglia na yun, or when you put them together or make them communicate with one another, you will form what is called here as the sympathetic chain or the sympathetic trunk. So, iisa lang yun. Okay? So, pag nagdikit-dikit yung mga white communicating ramae, it will form a sympathetic trunk. And the enlargements of cell body is called the prevertebral or collateral ganglia. Now, your preganglionic neuron will synapse or will connect with your postganglionic neuron. Okay? So now let's talk about the postganglionic neuron. So nandito na tayo, no? Lumagpas na tayo sa sympathetic chain natin. Now, if you will notice, though, yung mga fibers that coming out of your sympathetic chain, they come to a place called a ganglion. Kaya siya tinawag na preganglionic. Kasi sila yung fibers bago dumating sa ganglion. Now, these fibers arising from the ganglion are your postganglionic neurons. So, saan daw nagmumula? What's their location? From the sympathetic trunk. Ito yung trunk mo, di ba? Your sympathetic trunk. And your prevertebral ganglia. This one. So, pwedeng dito, pwede rin dito mag-originate. And when they come out, they are part of your gray communicating ramae. So kung si preganglionic is white, your postganglionic is gray. And they become a part of your spinal nerves. And what do? They innervate your blood vessels, your erector pili muscles. Saan nakikita yung erector pili muscles? Sa skin, if you still remember from your FAPC. And then your sweat glands as well. So that's your postganglionic neuron. Saan nag-originate ulit? Pwedeng sa sympathetic chain or trunk. Pwede rin na sa prevertebral or collateral ganglion. Tapos ito sila, no? Yung dotted lines na yan, going to the different organs, yan yung iyong postganglionic neuron. Now, inside your ganglia, di ba? Inside your ganglion, you will find many interneurons. Itong mga maliliit na nerve na to, these are what we call interneurons. They are also called SIF or small intensely fluorescent cells. And their job is to allow the interconnection of the different nerves in that area. Okay? So, they are either dopaminergic and inhibitory. So, yun yung trabaho ng mga interneurons natin. In terms of neurotransmitters, iba-ibang neurotransmitters din yung ginagamit. Depende kung pre- or post-ganglionic and also kung anong effect yung gusto mong ipalabas. So, please do remember, guys, na yung pre-ganglionic ng sympathetic division uses acetylcholine. Yun yung nilalabas na to, no? This is your preganglionic neuron. And it releases acetylcholine. And then you have here your ganglion. You'll have your interneurons here. And then you have your postganglionic neuron. And commonly, in the sympathetic division, ang neurotransmitter is norepinephrine. Kaya NE. Norepinephrine. So why did I say commonly? Because there is an exception. In the sweat glands and in the blood vessels, ano ang neurotransmitter ng ano nila, ng kanilang postganglionic neuron? It also uses acetylcholine. Okay? Sympathetic division to most sweat glands uses acetylcholine for pre- and for post. While for the other parts of the body, acetylcholine for pre, norepinephrine for post. Now, your norepinephrine is usually accompanied by epinephrine kasi kine-create naman sila from the same place, which is your adrenal medulla. Specifically, what types of cells? Your chromaffin cells. Pero mas marami talaga nakikreate ng norepinephrine. So, it's a 4:1 ratio. Okay po? Another neurotransmitter that is unique to the CIF cells or the interneurons is your dopamine. Diba? It is inhibitory. And then, you also have your vasoactive intestinal polypeptide or VIP. Usually, sinasamahan nito yung acetylcholine ng postganglionic parasympathetic fibers. So again, saan ba nakikita yung acetylcholine at postganglionic parasympathetic fibers? So postganglionic na gumagamit ng acetylcholine, sa sweat glands yan kadalasan. So in your sweat glands, you have acetylcholine and your VIP. Now, let's go to the parasympathetic division. It is also called your craniosacral or cholinergic system. Kung si sympathetic, it prepares your body for an emergency. Ito naman si parasympathetic, it prepares your body for rest or for digestion. So, pag magpapahinga, parasympathetic naman. So, what are the effects? It reduces heart rate. And it increases digestion and absorption. Kaya siya tinawag na rest and digest. That's the function of your parasympathetic. So in the parasympathetic division, simple lang. Post and preganglionic, anywhere in the body, uses acetylcholine. Okay? Pre and post uses acetylcholine. So baka may mga questions sa exam, no? Okay? Na if acetylcholine will be removed in all preganglionic or postganglionic neurons, what will be the effect? So, dapat ma-predict natin. Okay? So, your parasympathetic division can actually be divided into several divisions. First that we have here is your cranial division, no? At yung cranial division ng parasympathetic nervous system natin is actually in cooperation with four cranial nerves. The first one is the oculomotor nerve or cranial nerve 3. Mamaya, pupuntahan natin anong effect niyan sa muscles of the eye. Also, you have your facial nerve, which I discussed in that uploaded lecture about cranial nerve part 2. Sinabi natin doon na yung facial nerve natin, it's a mixed nerve, di ba? Meron siyang sensory, meron din siyang parasympathetic, and motor abilities. So, yung parasympathetic division ng facial nerve, alam mo anong ginagawa niya? It supplies your salivary glands. No? Sinusupplyan niya yung salivary gland to produce salivation. Kasi diba kapag magdadigest, kapag kumain, you need increased amount of saliva. So, you have your superior salivatory nucleus and your submandibular ganglion. Itong dalawang to, they help in the production of saliva. On the other hand, you have your pterygopalatine ganglion. Para sa naman to? It stimulates your lacrimal gland. Anong ginagawa ng lacrimal gland? Gumagawa ng luha or tears. Okay? Other cranial nerves that are coordinating with your parasympathetic division includes your cranial nerve number 9 or glossopharyngeal. Sinabi ko rin in our part 2 of the discussion ng cranial nerve na si glossopharyngeal, it also creates salivation but for a specific gland and that is your parotid gland. As you can see here, your otic ganglion is in charge of projecting postganglionic fibers to the parotid gland. While your inferior salivatory nucleus, napunta naman siya kay otic ganglion. So basically, ganun pa rin. Inferior salivatory nucleus will project fibers to the otic ganglion. Otic ganglion will project fibers to the parotid gland. So basically, pareho lang sila ng effect. Lastly, for the cervical division is your vagal nerve or cranial nerve number 10, which has three fibers. Una is your dorsal motor nucleus. Second is your intramural ganglia. And the third is nucleus ambiguous. So, iba-iba sila ng ginagawa. Si dorsal motor nucleus, it controls your visceral organs. Okay? Visceral organs. Yung intramural ganglia, it controls your thorax and abdomen. Thorax and abdomen. While your nucleus ambiguous, it controls the heart. Okay? Next, we have your sacral division. So, si sacral division naman, nag-originate siya from S2 to S4. Okay? From S2 to S4. So, usually, yung mga ganglions nila, malapit na dun sa organ. No? Malapit na dun sa end organ nila. So, the sacral division innervates the pelvic nerves, encompassing your lower abdomen, kasama na rin yung pelvic viscera, even, guys, yung large intestine kasama na, no? Urinary bladder, pati yung genital viscera. So, si sacral division yung nagko-control ng micturition or pag-ihi, defecation or pagdumi, and even sexual function. Okay? So, you don't want this division of the autonomics to be damaged, or else wala ka ng control over urination, wala ka ng control over defecation, tapos wala ka pang control over your sexual organs, 'di ba? Ang pangit naman. So the neurotransmitters used by your parasympathetic division, as mentioned kanina, you have your acetylcholine, VIP, 'di ba? Kasama ng acetylcholine 'yan sa postganglionic, and then you also have your nitric oxide, which is usually found in your smooth muscles for relaxation of smooth muscles and penile erection. Okay? And the third division of the autonomic nervous system, as mentioned, is your enteric division. Ang enteric division ay nagpa-function through the use of two plexuses. Okay? These are your Meissner plexus, also known as submucosal, and the myenteric or Auerbach plexus. Pakinggan nyo to, baka itanong sa exam. Your submucosal or Meissner plexus controls the glands. The glands, especially in your digestive system. Di ba, kailangan ng maraming secretions sa digestive system. So, ang nagkocontrol sa glands na yon is your Meissner plexus or submucosal plexus. Also, para mag-create tayo ng poops, di ba? Kailangan nag-move yung food na ini-eat natin. So, that is controlled by your myenteric or Auerbach plexus. It controls the movement of the gut. So, your enteric division receives both sympathetic and parasympathetic input. Bakit nga ba siya hiniwalay from parasympathetic and sympathetic? Kasi ang only role ng enteric division is to control the gastrointestinal motility. Okay po? Now, if there is any damage in these nerves, then we will be able to feel what we call visceral pain. What is visceral pain? Visceral pain is a diffuse pain felt in involuntary organs. So, di ba kapag, let's say, meron kang skeletal muscle pain, kapag ginagalaw mo yung muscle, doon siya pinaka-painful. Now, how about kapag internal organ ang may damage? Do we feel pain? Yes, and it's called visceral pain. Diffuse kasi hindi mo malaman saang organ galing. No, it can come from anywhere in the body or any internal organ. So usually, when we say visceral pain, they are not reliably associated with organ injury. Meaning, pwedeng may masakit sa left side, pero ang nagkukos pala is an organ found on the right side. So ganun siya, diffuse, kumakalat. So paano ba nagkakaroon ng visceral pain? Kapag number one, may distension of any viscus. Ang viscous, ibig sabihin nun, hollow organ or isang body part or body organ na usually empty. So, dapat empty siya. Pero kapag nag-distend or kapag nag-start na lumaki yung isang organ na dapat empty, then it can lead to visceral pain. Pwede rin kapag masyadong malakas yung contraction ng mga intestines natin, tapos meron pang ischemia doon sa isang part ng intestine, then we can feel pain. What else? Mechanical stimulation. Diba? When an organ is hyperemic, sabi ng hyperemic, masyadong maraming blood flow doon, then it can lead to visceral pain. And lastly, when you are experiencing heart attack, as such as myocardial ischemia, magre-release yung body mo ng kinin. Ano yung kinin or kinin? Ito ay mga pain, pain-inducing substances. So, ito mga visceral pain na to, they are usually referred. Ito yung ibig sabihin natin, no? Na, what do we mean by referred muna? It is the false reference or localization of a painful stimuli. Meaning, katulad nito, kunyari heart ang may problema. So, sabi dito, ito ang heart, di ba? Alam nyo ba na kapag may heart problem ka, damay din yung left side of the face, the neck, the arm, no? Damay po lahat yan. So, Doc, bakit nadadamay even the face and the arm? And nandito lang naman yung heart. That is what you call your referred visceral pain. Pumupunta yung pain sa isang local area in the body, pero hindi talaga doon nag-o-originate yung pain. Diba? So, andito ba ang heart? Sa face, para dyan mag-originate ang pain? Hindi naman. Nasa chest naman ang heart. So, bakit dito magkaka-pain? Kasi nag-refer na yung pain. Okay? So, this can further be explained by the convergence and projection mechanism that happens in angina pectoris. What is angina pectoris? This is chest pain caused by a heart attack. Yan. So, dito makikita natin kung paano nangyayari yung visceral pain. So, ang painful impulses ng myocardium or muscles of the heart is projected to the sensory dorsal horn relay neurons of T1 to T4. So, yung sensory neurons ng heart natin, aakyat po yan, papunta sa ating spinal cord, at yung kanilang area na nakakasakop sa kanila is your thoracic segment T1 to T4. On the same T1 to T4 area, using the same neuron, it also relays cutaneous input from dermatomes. Diba? Ang T1, meron talaga yung dermatome, T2, T3 hanggang T4. Lahat naman yan meron, diba? Except C1. So, bukod doon sa sensory sensation ng heart, daladala rin ng T1 to T4 yung kanilang dermatomes. At pag umakyat yan hanggang spinal cord and brain, it will be carried by your spinothalamic and thalamocortical tracts. Diba? Spinothalamic, pain and temperature. Remember? Spinothalamic, pain and temperature. And of course, pagdating sa thalamus, dadali naman siya ng thalamocortical. It connects your thalamus and your cortex. That is why when there is angina pectoris or chest pain due to a heart problem, you will also feel pain on the left side of the arm and the left side of the face. Kasi yun din yung pinoprovide na dermatome ng T1 to T4. That is the reason for your referred visceral pain. So, all of these mga fibers are carried by your GVA fibers or general visceral afferent. Diba? Sila yung nagbibigay sensation. So, afferent. So, most visceral reflexes and organic sensations are mediated by your parasympathetic afferent fibers. Usually kasi si sympathetic, very motor siya. Si parasympathetic, siya yung medyo maraming afferent. So, of course, you have your GVA cell bodies, which are usually found pwedeng sa dorsal horn, you know, GVA, pwedeng sa dorsal horn, pwede rin sa dorsal root ganglia na, or sa iba't ibang ganglia ng mga cranial nerves natin. Afterwards, after ng cell body, magka-create na yan ng pain fiber, diba? That will go out of your spinal cord. And usually, they are found in your white communicating rami. Okay? Afterwards, after lumabas ng GVA mo, no? Afterwards, you have your GVA reflex fibers, which will accompany both sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. At saan daw sila nag-end up? Sa solitary nucleus that mediate your gag reflex. So, para makarating siya kay heart, syempre kailangan meron siyang may area siya doon, no? So, you have your carotid sinus. The carotid sinus is this enlargement. Itong parang enlarged area of the common carotid artery. This is your common carotid artery. And then, this will become your external carotid and then internal carotid. So, in that dilated area of the common carotid, you will find your carotid sinus. And then, your carotid sinus contains baroreceptors, if you still remember from our cardio discussion in FAPC. So, what you will find in that carotid sinus is your carotid body, also known as glomus caroticum. So, anong ginagawa ng carotid body mo? It is innervated by cranial nerve number 9 and cranial nerve number 10 para makontrol nila yung heart natin. So, here are some autonomic innervations of some selected organs. And then later on, papakita ko yung buong list ng lahat ng organs. Or can I just go to that quickly, no? Yeah, the ANS effects of the different organs. So you have to get familiar with this, no? So like sa pupil, kapag sympathetic, anong effect niya? It dilates your pupil. Kapag parasympathetic, it constricts. So, I want you to be able to familiarize yourself with this. Anong effect ng sympathetic and parasympathetic sa iba't ibang areas of the body? Glands, heart, lungs, gastrointestinal, liver, kidney, and even sexual. Okay, kung anong ginagawa nila. Sorry, let me just go back to that area. Yan. So, let's go first to the eyes, okay? So, paano ba nakokontrol ng sympathetic nervous system natin ng eyes natin? It begins with the ciliospinal center of Budge. Unfortunately, wala siya sa image na ito. But what does it do? It is actually a neuron na nag-o-originate sa hypothalamus at bumababa papunta ng T1 to T2 area. Specifically sa intermediolateral cell column. So let's say this is your T1 and T2 area and there is a fiber that goes down. That's your ciliospinal center of Budge. Pagdating dito sa T1 to T2, it will again project preganglionic fibers via the sympathetic trunk to the superior cervical ganglion. So, asan yung ganglion na yun? This is your ganglion. Superior cervical sympathetic ganglion. Ito siya. No? So, from T1 to T2, pupunta daw yung fiber natin papunta doon sa superior cervical sympathetic ganglion. Once it reaches this area, it will send a post-ganglionic. Post na kasi tapos na tayo sa ganglion, di ba? Post-ganglionic fibers via the internal carotid artery or the carotid plexus or sinus, and then it will be able to reach the muscles of the eye. Now, the pupillodilator fibers and even the tarsal muscles of Müller kasama na dyan sa nakokontrol sympathetically ng eyes natin. For your parasympathetic naman, it begins with your Edinger-Westphal nucleus. Edinger-Westphal. It will project anteriorly to cranial nerve number 3, N3, papunta ng ciliary ganglion. So, this is your preganglionic. Diba? Pagdating ng ciliary ganglion, ito na yung ganglia, magsasend na siya ng short fibers papunta ng mata. Okay, short fibers. and this allows our pupils to react to light. Next, we have your blood vessels. So, in-underline ko na kasi iba-iba sila ng effect, okay? Sa arteries, sa veins, capillaries, and even cerebral blood vessels. So, sa arteries and arterioles, iba-iba ha, pwedeng gawin ng sympathetic nervous system mo is to constrict your cutaneous, meaning sa skin, and splanchnic blood vessels by stimulating alpha receptors. Okay, I want you to read that again para ma-digest natin. On the other hand, still sympathetic, it causes dilation of skeletal muscle arteries. So kung sa una, constriction, dito naman, dilation. Still the same via the alpha receptors. And then lastly, you have your blood vessels which are not affected by your parasympathetic stimulation. Okay? How about in the heart? So, itong heart natin, dalawang group yung nagsusupply dito. Your T1 to T5, and then the three cervical ganglia of the sympathetic neurons, or usually C1, C2, C3. So, you can see them here in this image. C1, 2, 3, no? Pupunta siya ng heart. And then your T1 to 5, usually, it continues to supply naman the ventricle and the atrium of the heart. Okay, so sino nagsusupply sa ventricle and atrium of the heart? Your T1 to T5. Diba? So what is the effect on the heart? Increased heart rate, increased force of cardiac contractility. Sa parasympathetic naman, pinapadaan nila yan through nucleus ambiguous. Si nucleus ambiguous, siya yung nagko-control sa heart natin via cranial nerve number 10. Okay po. So what will be the effect of parasympathetic input on the heart? It lowers the strength and the rate of cardiac contraction. Bladder naman, urinary bladder o pag-ihi is predominantly parasympathetic. But in some patients, they would usually activate their sympathetic para lang makaihi sila. So your sympathetic input comes from T12 to L3 and it controls the detrusor muscles and internal sphincter. Sorry about that. Your parasympathetic input comes from S2 to S3. Ang trabaho naman ng parasympathetic input natin is to result in the emptying of the bladder. So, pag parasympathetic, di ba, rest and digest. So, anong gagawin mo pag nag-rest? Iihi ka na. Yan. So, if masira yung parasympathetic input ng bladder natin, it can lead to atonic bladder, meaning di mo na nakokontrol yung ihi mo. Bigla na lang siyang tutulo, no? Yan. Also, some other important parts of your bladder is the somatomotor input from S2 to S4, the sensory input to the spinal cord, the ascending pathway for the bladder, which controls the urge to void, no? And the upper motor neuron input, which controls the voluntary urination and many other symptoms that you can see here in the slide. So lastly, you have your ANS effects. As mentioned, pinakita ko na to kanina. So that's it. Actually, no, ma-memorize lang natin to lahat ng effects, then you're good to go na. That's it. Thank you, guys.